Slab City, the last free place in America. No electricity. Yeah, there's lots of videos out there if you're interested about Slab City. Mostly they show the negative aspects. I spent a few nights there and I had a good time. Here are a few of my takeaways from a little time spent at the last free place in America. Hey, vinyl community, and welcome YouTubers from everywhere. Hey, some of you young folks may not remember, we haven't always had electricity. A long time ago, you had to hear music live. We're going to have some of that coming up. But the first electrical recording was done by Victor in 1925 featuring Seeger Ellis. Here we have a 1929 Victor orthophonic credenza phonograph, wind-up, little arm muscles, all that's required. But the music was pretty good. Let's try a little Jimmy Rogers and his blue yodel.
I'm going to California where they sleep out every night. I'm going to California where they sleep out every night.
We sleep out every night. Before the early phonographs, it was all live. Yep, if you didn't hear it live, you didn't hear it. Well, they got live at Slab City on a place called The Range, as you see here in the picture. The Range has live music. They have people show up from different places. They have locals play. They have open mic. They have a person goes by the name of Jinxie Bonesaw, who is in charge, the stage manager at The Range at Slab City. She'd been there, I think, for about a year. She's doing a great job. They got that place straightened out. They got it managed. They got it going on. And often two or three times a week, they have live music from The Range at Slab City. So check some of those out. The night I was there on Sunday night, they had a group from Portland, Oregon, two people, I call it noise music, maybe I wouldn't call it music. They had recorded sounds on tape, which they played back then through devices that distorted and modified the sound, and I don't know what it was. It was interesting, though. Here's just a little clip. Yeah, for lights and power, they're having to run a generator. Well, what the heck can you do if you don't have electricity? Solar power. Here's a couple of examples of maybe what you could do if you want some hi-fi on solar power. Of course, some places have big solar power installations where you can run a real hi-fi. But what's lots of the kids doing? They're doing the music on their smartphone. They're recording it on the smartphone. They're listening to it on the smartphone. And may not be quite hi-fi, but that's where it's at now. Hey. Hey, all you audiophiles. About this speaker system they have out here for quality sound. A V88.
I think it's more of a robot.
But I don't see a USB port.
I think, is there a USB port on this car?
I bet there is.
This electric car?
Depends when this car was built.
When do you think this car was built? Warren found the USB ports on the Cyborg. Harry.
This is what happens. This is what happens when you don't play the right kind of music. This is what happens to your audio system. So be careful what music you're listening to. No electricity, no problem. No musical talent, no problem. We got an age-old solution. Slabs right away, but I'll be taking my audiophile hi-fi solutions with me when I go. Keep them spinning and see you all down the trail.
Happy trails to you until we meet again.